I should have mentioned also, there's a number of different ways you can get to the user preferences. You can come down to the window options and select user preferences. That's one option. You can also come up to the file and go to user preferences here. And it usually tells you the shortcut key. So for me, it's command comma. So, and this will actually bring up a separate window. It's completely defiant to Blender's non-overlapping window concept. But yeah, you should be able to come here and then turn on things like emulate three-button mouse, emulate numpad, and adjust the center view to cursor options. So, so if you come up here, usually it's set on interface, I think, when you open it. You want to click on the input panel.
Yeah.
Okay. And then you want to come to emulate three-button mouse and click that and emulate numpad and click that. Yeah. Okay. This one, it's not as important, but I like to set it since you probably, you don't have a numpad on your laptop.
Yeah.
I want to come down to 3D view and 3D view global. Turn on edit. Okay. I just clicked restore, so this is what it should look like in the default setting. And I'm just going to change view selected from numpad period to period, and center view to cursor from control numpad period to control period. So as you can see, there are probably 1,000 shortcut keys in Blender, and you can adjust pretty much any of them. Yep.
So if you close the Blender and reopen it, it usually opens in the whatever you
Oh, the default.
The
right.
How do you get to the default?
Yeah, so if you come down here, where it says save as default, just click that, and then it should be anytime you open up Blender again, it'll have everything saved. You can also come down to Save User Settings or hit Control U.
I don't want whatever it was like.
Oh, you want to load the factory settings.
Yeah.
I see, yeah. So, right. So you just come down to File and click on Load Factory Settings. Okay.
So when you start up Blender, it seems to maximize to the full screen. Is there a way to tell it to save the last window size that you opened at?
Yeah, you know, I think actually that's part of the user preferences, I think, because so you can scale the whole size of the window just by grabbing your bottom corner. So if I were to, say, be here and then click on save as command comma and then save as default, I think now if I open Blender, so it keeps the same dimensions for me. I don't know if it works the same for you, but.
I didn't try that.
Yeah. I don't want it to open that small, so I'm going to come back. Okay. So one part of the tools panel that's kind of useful is just this operator little thing here you can see, which you can expand and collapse. And basically what this tells you is if you were to do a transformation, like say press G and move it, and then I let go or I left click to confirm, we can pull this up just to expand. So it gives you, Oh, I just completely made that disappear. Okay.
I think it will be to the top.
I did? Oh, I see. It just completely disappeared. Well, you know what you do? You close Blender and you open it back up. honestly, so Blender 2.5 is still a little new for me, and I don't know. This has happened a couple times where it just seems to magically, this thing seems to disappear. Just going to leave it there for now and show you that if I just click G, and they have scroll, you can scroll up and down. But this shows you all the different types of things you could do. So you could actually fix it. Like, after you've actually done the confirmation, you can choose, like, the constraint axis. You can choose the degree to which you actually transformed. You can drag and slide on one of these positions. And you can't, I'm changing the Z axis, but you can't see because that's our, that's normal to our plane of view. And we're in perspective, we're in orthographic perspective, so that's not going to matter. Okay, anyway. So generally speaking, when you make a transformation of some sort, there'll probably be some sort of summary or some options that kind of come up in this little operator panel, which you can, of course, toggle, expand, and collapse. Okay.
One thing you can do is enter a specific precise value in there. Just by typing the number.
Yes.
That's right. Sometimes important.
Right. So, yes. So that was going to be the next thing I wanted to mention, which is no, that's good. I need these reminders because otherwise I just get like, woo, off, a little off base. All right. So, Okay, so yeah, so good point. So if we want to transform by a particular value, then you can say, let's say we want to move it by 2 Blender units along the x-axis in the positive direction. So then what you do is you just hit gx2, and what you'll notice is in the bottom left, it shows you 2 Blender units, 2.0000 along global x. And that means it's going to move you two units along the global x-axis. Hit enter, and you will have incorporated that. Oop, bless you. And as Monica just said, you can see that we just did the translation along the x-axis by 2 Blender units. Of course, you can also enter it here. If you don't like that and you want to do 1.5, you can enter 1.5 or 10 if you wanted. And now it's way over here. Bring it back to 0. You can essentially negate the translation we just made. We can come back. So the same thing happens for the other types of for scaling and rotating. So if you hit R, you'll rotate. And you see in the bottom left, it starts to indicate like what you've done to rotate. If you start just manipulating with your cursor, you'll see that it actually is showing you in the number of degrees rotated along the plane, the view plane, how much you're actually rotating your object. Okay? But if I want to specifically just rotate it, say 45 degrees, at any point before I've confirmed the rotation, I can just click I can type in 45 and hit enter. And again, in this little panel, it'll show you your last operation, and you could decide that you want to select it, or you can retype. So you can drag, you can actually go up one unit at a time here, or you can click right on the X and choose you want to do 90 degrees, right? Or you want to do it specifically only along the x-axis. And then now this will stay up as long as you don't do any other type of manipulations to your scene. If suddenly I do another manipulation and say I grab it, it's going to just erase. Well, it's going to remove those options, and those are now fixed. Unless you say clear your rotation and your scaling and your rotation. Okay. And so, all right. So rotation is the number value is in degrees. I think you can change that in the settings somewhere to radians if you prefer radians, but it does it by degrees. And the translation does it by Blender units. So you'll soon get familiar with Blender units. And if you want to scale, it'll do it by proportion. So if I were to hit S to scale and then just 2, it'll double the size of it'll double the X, Y, and Z dimensions of the object. I can hit enter, and again, of course, it shows you you've increased the size of the object in all three dimensions by a value of 2. If I want to make it a tenth of the size, I can hit S 0.1, and now I've made it 1/10 of the size. Okay, so that's a way we can get very explicit control over the different types of manipulations that you might want to do to an object. In addition, if you want to grab it and move it on your own, and you want it to be by fixed units, but you don't have to enter the number, you want to kind of play around with it and see how it looks nice, you can actually hit Control while you're trying to, I think it's default set, if you hit grab, say, for example, and then Control, it'll actually click to whatever the most relevant Blender unit is for the scale of the objects that you're looking at. So now you see it's popping along to the grid in terms of Blender units. And if you look down in the bottom left, it'll show you how many units you've moved. And of course, it's moving by whole Blender units, integer values. So that's Control. If you add in Shift, you get a finer control. So now I can say hold Shift, and now I can actually move it by tenths of Blender units. And that'll work at all different scales. And that'll tend to work for rotation and scale as well. Okay. So if I want to, scale, I can hit S and then Control, and it'll actually go by tenths of a proportion. So it'll go by 0.1 value. If I hit Shift, it'll go by hundredths. And so this gives you some way to control specific adjustments without actually have to entering any numbers. And rotation, of course, it'll usually pop it to, it'll go in increments of 5 degrees. So if you want to be very precise, don't want to have to enter numbers. Here we just rotated it by 45 degrees, and now we've got it pretty well under control. Okay. Any questions right now? No? Okay. Okay, so let's talk about other objects, and let's talk about editing the shape of this default cube, all right? Because it's just a really plain cube. It's just sitting here. And what this actually is, so there's a lot of different types of Blender objects or objects in 3D graphics in general. We have things called meshes. We have things called NURBS and curves and meta objects. And so this particular object is a mesh. And what that means is a series of vertices, points in Cartesian coordinates in space, that are actually just connected by lines, and then those lines connect to make faces. And so we can transition from, if you notice down here on the bottom panel, it says object mode. Now that's the mode that we've been working in entirely right now. And that's where you want to be if you want to manipulate the object's basic object features or characteristics, like location, rotation, and scaling. But if you want to get down to actually like changing the shape, which is where you start to get really interesting, you want to press Tab key, and you'll tab into Edit mode. And now you'll have access to the parameters that control the shape of the object. And now we can start doing some interesting things with this plain default cube.